We've got Earl the Pearl Monroe. Thanks for being on Terp Talk yesterday, on the Sports Maven yesterday. We appreciate having you on the radio, man. Sandy, you seem like you know each other pretty well. You have any questions, basketball questions for Earl?
Well, no. I told Earl that if you remember, the 1969 All-Star Game was here, and I told him I saw Oscar Robertson at an event like this, and I said, Oscar, you know Earl should have won that MVP. He goes, no, he shouldn't. I go, yeah, he should. He was the best that day. You know, there's not a, other than Lenny Moore, for me, you know, a sports idol for Harold, my friend Harold and I, growing up here as high school seniors, coming and watching him every day was the greatest treat that we had as high schoolers. And it's just an honor to have Earl here today to be a part of this great event, to raise awareness about prostate cancer and make a difference in the community. So thank you for Terp Talk for helping us do that.
Well, it's our pleasure. You don't often get to see a man who's won an NCAA basketball championship, one of the 50 greatest players in history, an NBA champion, all of those things, and he played here. How did you get from Philadelphia to Winston-Salem?
Well, for the most part, you know, I wasn't recruited. A guy who went to Winston-Salem recommended me to go down to Winston-Salem, and that's how I got there. I actually had to go down there, make the team, then take my SATs and pay my first year. So, you know, it wasn't a straight shot, but thank goodness it happened. I'm a better person for it. And Sandy, I told Oscar Robertson a month ago that I should have won it too.
So we agree.
No question.
So you played for one of the, I guess, greatest coaches in the history of basketball. Somebody out there yelled Big House. It's Big House Gaines. What did he impart to you when you're scoring 40 points a game for him?
Well, it wasn't too much he could impart after that 40, but he was a great coach. He, you know, steered me well. He gave me a lot of life lessons and things like that, which he did for most of his, you know, players. Most of his players graduated, and I'm one of those guys. So, you know, I'm very thankful for the opportunity to have gone to Winston-Salem and to have participated and played for a coach of his stature.
I see that there's a book. I should have brought one of the books over. We're going to picture that and throw it in here. What's in the book? Why should we go out and buy your book?
Well, it's a tell-all type of book that I had done back in 2013. When I was getting ready to go out on a tour for the book, I had my knee scoped and then it got infected, and I was never able to get out and promote the book. From what I gather from other people, the book is a very good book. I haven't read the whole book because I told the publisher, you know, the book is over 400 pages. I don't read anything over 250 pages, but you know, I edited the book myself, so I think it's pretty good.
All right, well, I know you got a line of about 100 people waiting to see you.
Sign those books and the pictures.
Okay.
Earl, thank you so much.
All right,
couldn't thank you enough for being here.
All right, we'll see you there.
Hey,
see you there. Good to see you.